हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर मोहम्मद सिराजुल हक फैजी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, लंगर सिंह कॉलेज, मुजफ्फरपुर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शंस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट व्हाट इज पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शंस। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर I already explained about pericyclic reactions. In this reaction I will go basic because some student requested me, please make a very simple what is the pericyclic reactions. So in this video I am going to discuss about very basic of pericyclic reactions. So what is the type of pericyclic reactions? So this is one type, electrocyclic reactions. So cyclic, that word is very important, and electrocyclic means transformations of electrons in cyclic systems. You see here, this is open and all pi bond taking in the reactions. You see, no pi bond in the rest. Even all bonds here is engaged and making this cyclic product. So what is difference between this and this? One new sigma bond is formed, this one. That is very important. What is the result of this electrocyclic reactions? One new sigma bond is formed. That's why this is cyclic and this is not cyclic. Now this is the cyclizations, ring closing. Now same way, you have to open this ring. You see? So again this bond will break and open chain structure will form. So this is the example of electrocyclic reactions, where cyclizations through movement of electrons forming sigma bond, and the reverse way, again if you open this ring you will get the same product. So in overall what will happen here? Formation of sigma bond. Just keep it this in mind. Now sigma tropic rearrangement, very good examples. Little bit confusion with electrocyclic reactions, but if you focus on the point where I am going to locate you, then you will identify the difference between electrocyclic and sigma tropic rearrangement. See, in electrocyclic reaction this is in conjugations, but in sigma tropic rearrangement you see this double bond is not under conjugations, and this bond will break and another bond will form. So one new sigma bond is formed as another break. Here after breaking new sigma bond is formed. Here there is no cyclizations. You see, that is the main difference. No conjugations, no cyclizations. So this is the sigma tropic. What is sigma tropic rearrangement? So formation of sigma bond is zero, because only one sigma bond break, another sigma will form. So here electrocyclic means you look at the cyclic product. But in sigma tropic rearrangement you should not look at the cyclic product. Getting my point? Next, cycloadditions. Here is cyclized product like the electrocyclic reactions, but here two partner. This is the 4 pi electron, this is 2 pi, 4 plus 2 cycloadditions. And upon opening they give the two products. So what in here? Here two sigma bond is forming. That is deviate from the electrocyclic addition. Just keep in mind. So that is entirely different. In cycloaddition, addition means two things combined together. Electrocyclic reactions, though no additions. So, friends, now you understand cycloaddition reactions. You see what types of example this is? Electrocyclic reactions. This is the ring opening. What type of examples? Electrocyclic reactions. So, friend, in electrocyclic reactions, you will consider this double bond, this double bond, this one, in this form. Just open it. Just remove this structure from your brain and put this structure in your brain. And then what will happen here? Formation of new sigma bond, new sigma. So which last straw orbital involved in the sigma bonds we have to consider. So all the time you have to check it. You just check it is open and open and closing. So opening and closing. You see the closing. So friend, hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel, share it with your friend, and thanks for watching.